Thank you so much for being here.
My God.
Yeah.
This is like my make-a-wish or something like that.
No, we've met each other a couple times. I got a chance to see you perform at Dennis Leary's charity, Comics Come Home in Boston. And you crushed. And I was like, wow, I had heard about it. But you were so great that night. And I was like, and I got a chance to say hi to you and talk to you. And you said that, I go, it's a pleasure meeting you. And you said, we've actually we've met before.
We have met. We met when I was 15 years old.
Yeah, and I was like, oh, yeah, of course. I remember that.
Yeah.
You were there.
Yeah, you look the same.
You were there. Yeah, of course. You look a little taller, but yeah. But you go, I actually have a photo, mm-hmm. and you have a photo of you and I. Where were we, buddy? What was this?
This was the premiere of Fever Pitch, because I worked for the Red Sox, the baseball team.
Yeah. You worked for them at 15?
Yeah, I worked in PR. I was like, someone found me like hanging around outside the ballpark and brought me inside and was like, can we keep him? And they're like, oh, sure. So, I guess that's totally fine.
He got raised.
By the way, that photo in that picture, like this is my, I'm actually 16 years old in this picture. I look like, I showed it to my dad. He's like, you look like 9 years old.
Yeah, you do look like, yeah.
And that's my bar mitzvah suit. Like,
I was gonna say, it's a nice suit, you look sharp.
Yeah, yeah, well, I look like, I still look like, by the way, I broke out in acne so hard like 2 months after this, so I'm so grateful that this is from like that time as opposed to, like my sweat needed four-wheel drive to get down my face. Like I had so much.
So much acne. Oh,
yeah, it was brutal.
It was a rough one.
Yeah, it was a rough one, but this was like a nice, bright, shiny moment.
Yeah, and you knew how to tie a tie and everything?
Actually, no. I showed up on the red carpet with no tie, and Tom Brady was coming down the carpet, and he went, where's your tie? And I was too embarrassed to tell him I didn't know how to put one on, so I pulled it out of my pocket, and Tom Brady was like, come here, man. And so, like, yeah. And so, like, I have such love for Tom Brady.
Tom Brady tied your tie?
Tom Brady tied my tie, like, I remember someone taking a picture, and I'm like, I need to find this picture of Tom Brady putting my tie on.
Yeah.
Because, like, even when he left Boston, we were like, oh, I hate Tom Brady. I was like, well, he knows how to put on a tie. He's, like, pretty good.
Yeah. So you, like, love Tom Brady.
I worship Tom. An incredible winner, an incredible guy. Like, yeah. I'm such a... There's a joke about him in my special. Like, I'm just... I love Tom Brady so much. But yeah.
I'm happy that you interviewed me for this thing. Was the interview okay? Did it turn out all
right? Yeah, it was pretty good. It was for the Red Sox Kids Nation newsletter. And we, of course. Really, really serious bit of journalism. And, but also, actually, I violated journalistic principle because one of the producers of the film was like, notice I had my mom's Entertainment Weekly with you guys and Johnny Damon on the cover. And he's like, would you like me to get Jimmy and Drew to sign that for you? And I was like, oh, yes, please. And he never gave it back to me. And so when I was on Drew Barrymore's show last year, I told her that, and she gave me a signed copy of the magazine. So now, I mean, I feel like I should ask you to, like, finish the job, if that's okay.
Yeah, I have to.
This will be on eBay tomorrow, if anybody...
I'm gonna say Alex...
Yeah, sign it nice and big so the British know who the boss is, right? You know, but like...
I was gonna just sign it there. I was just gonna put Nomar, so I'm gonna put Johnny Damon's on the cover. That's, I remember this. God, look how young baby Jimmy on that one, man. Oh, my God. That was the best wig you can buy at the time. But,
dude, yeah, you look the same here, which is...
No, I do not. But I want to talk to you about your HBO special. Mm-hmm. This is unbelievable. Congratulations on this. It's coming out this Saturday. Alex Edelman, Just for Us. I'm going to read a couple of reviews really quickly. The New York Times called the show a phenomenon. Variety said it was hilarious and irresistible. Washington Post said, get ready for this one, Just for Us has been chiseled to diamond-cut perfection. It's a joyous, uproarious 90-minute show from one of the funniest minds of this generation or any generation.
That...
What?
That is... I can say that that's...
Holy...
I mean, that's not true. It's really nice for, like, Mark Twain. Like, Mike Birbiglia, who's a great comedian.
I love Birbiglia.
Close friend of yours, been on the show a bunch. Birbiglia saw that quote, and for 2 months, every time he saw me, he'd be like, "Hey, Cicero, when I come over," and I was like, it's been really sweet and said such a gorgeous reception. I can't believe how well it's gone.
But it started at a tiny theater here, right, in the city.
It started at a theater. We had maybe 25, 30 people at the first show, and then it kind of went up and up and up.
Well, do you remember the tipping point where it blew up?
Sarah Jessica Parker put it on her Instagram.
Really?
Yeah, Sarah Jessica Parker put it on her Instagram. It's so weird to I owe Sarah Jessica Parker so much. I owe Sarah Jessica Parker, a woman I've met exactly one time, an extremely significant favor. She truly,
major.
She changed my life. I should have to buy her Manolo Blahnik shoes, every single.
Yes, you should.
She's an incredible person. SJP put on her Instagram and then no one could get a ticket. It's the craziest thing in the world. Yeah.
And what a great ride, and it's such a great special. How do we describe the special for anyone that's going in and watching this?
So I saw this tweet on the internet. I had some anti-Semitism point at me because I'm Jewish. Maybe sometimes people can tell that I'm Jewish because my name or my face or anything about me. But so someone tweeted something anti-Semitic, and I sort of followed the tweets down the rabbit hole a little bit, and I wound up at this meeting of white nationalists in Queens. And so I sat there for a little while. And so, everything sort of unfolds from there a little bit.
Oh, my gosh. I can't believe this. I want to show everyone a clip. Here's a peek at Alex Edelman just for us. Take a look at this.
Because running through this meeting is this thick vein of anti-Semitism, but I've never seen this kind of anti-Semitism before. It's almost exhilarating. It's thick, technicolor, weapons-grade, conspiracy theory-level anti. At some point, this guy two seats away from me, he just went, "Jews are sneaky and they're everywhere!" And I was like...
Oh my gosh. Alex Edelman, everybody! Alex Edelman, just for us! Premieres this Saturday at 10 p.m. on HBO. Congratulations, buddy. Please come back. Hey, hey.